What's good, YouTubers and YouTubettes? This is JBsports back again with another one. The ongoing verbal warfare between former WBC heavyweight champion Deontay the Bronze Bomber Wilder and former number one WBC contender Dillian Whyte, aka Cillian Whyte, has reached a fever pitch as Dillian Whyte is responding to the comments that Deontay Wilder made on Sky Sports and on ES News in Barbershop Conversation. When Wilder was talking about Dillian Whyte, he said, look, Dillian Whyte could have been got this work, but Dillian Whyte did not take the necessary steps to get a fight with me. I told him in black and white that he needed to fight Luis King Kong Ortiz, and if he would win that fight, he would get me next. Instead, he went into another direction and fought a rematch with Derek Chisora. Not once but twice I asked him to fight King Kong Ortiz, and both times he decided to do something else. That's why he didn't get the fight. And even before those times that I asked him to fight King Kong Ortiz, he could have got me previously before that. As I told his promoter, Eddie Hearn, aka Eddie the Con Artist, that I would fight Dillian Whyte. I would even fight him over there in the UK. But make sure you put Anthony Joshua on the end of that contract. And if you do that, it's on like a pot of neck bones. But his promoter, Eddie Hearn, said, hell to the now. Said no, didn't want it. So that's why that fight did not happen. Three separate occasions that fight could have happened and didn't happen. Scratch that. Four separate occasions. It could have happened because Dominique Brazil jumped into the fray. And Dominique Brazil said, look here, Dillian Whyte, so there won't be no misunderstanding, to keep the confusion down, I'll fight you, Dillian Whyte, and the winner of our fight can fight Deontay Wilder next. And Dillian Whyte did like red on Good Friday. When his son got his bike took and got knocked the fuck out, Red said, when Debo said, you want some of this, old man? And Red said, no. And that's the same thing that Dillian Whyte said, no, as he went and fought a rematch with Derek Chisora. So Dillian Whyte had plenty of opportunities to fight Deontay Wilder, long story being short, and he didn't do the necessary things to get the fight with Deontay Wilder. Now, Wilder said that Dillian Whyte is scum in between his toes. He also said that Dillian Whyte is shit on a tissue that he flushed down the toilet a year ago. He basically called Dillian Whyte a master's dog. Because you know what? Deontay Wilder said several times in the past that basically Dillian Whyte is AJ's guard dog. Every time he's trying to get a fight done with AJ, Eddie Hearn want to throw Dillian Whyte the guard dog at Deontay. When Deontay trying to chase greatness and become undisputed, Eddie Hearn wants to make a fight between Dillian Whyte and Deontay Wilder over there in the UK, telling Deontay, hey, you're going to make more money fighting Dillian Whyte than you made fighting over there in the PBC. You're going to make massive money over there in the UK. Because quiet is kept. That's the fight that Eddie Hearn really prefers. That's the fight he's been clamoring for the last 3 years. That's why Eddie Hearn was mad when Deontay Wilder did a 180 and decided not to show up when he was supposed to go over there and be a boxing analyst for the AJ Carlos Takam fight. He's supposed to be a guest boxing analyst for Sky Sports, if I'm not mistaken. And once he found out that AJ was not going to allow him to ring because he wanted to go over there and do a face to face with AJ after the fight to promote their fight. But AJ said he was going to have all kinds of security around there, that Wilder was not going to get in that ring. He was going to keep Wilder from getting that ring. He didn't want Wilder in that ring. He's going to have security over there. So, you know, Secret Service, the National Guard, He's going to probably have the UK army over there. He's going to have everybody over there keep Wilder out that ring. He did not want Wilder getting that ring. So Wilder decided not to come go over there. He said, what am I going over there for? That's the main reason why I'm going over there. You know, I'm supposed to be working as a boxing analyst. That's really the number two reason. You know, my number one reason going over there is I want to go face to face with AJ and start the promotion for our fight for Undisputed in the heavyweight division. And AJ and Eddie Hearn put a kaposh on that. And then they had the audacity, the unmitigated gall to get mad when Wilder, when he found out about that, didn't want to come over there. Because they wanted Deontay Wilder to go over there. And they wanted Dillian Whyte to run up on Deontay Wilder. Cause all kind of hysteria and had everybody talking. Man, did you see Dillian Whyte run up on Deontay Wilder? Getting Deontay Wilder face while he's trying to be an analyst and commentate and, you know, talk about the fights that's going down that night. They wanted Dillian Whyte to run up on him and talk all kind of noise, call him out his name, and, you know, and get people talking about a Wilder Whyte fight instead of a Wilder AJ fight, which was the reason why Wilder was going over there in the first place. He wanted to go face to face with AJ because he wanted to start to promote that fight, get people clamoring for that matchup. But Eddie Hearn and Dillian Whyte had other plans. So let's go back that far. And those guys have been number one contender for a minute. I give them that. But that 462 days, whatever how many days they say he was mandatory, that's a bunch of BS. That's fabrication, once again, by Eddie Hearn and Dillian Whyte. That's one thing they do over there under Matchroom Boxing, boy. They all about propaganda over there. They present stuff out there that ain't even true. And you got to be smarter than that, or you got to do your homework and find out what's really true and what's really ain't true. And that ain't true. He ain't been no mandatory for that long. He was number one contender for a while. But the mandatory was Dominique Brazil. That's why he got his shot at Deontay Wilder. But that's neither here nor there. Let me know your thoughts about Dillian Whyte's response to Deontay Wilder. And his response was, look, Deontay Wilder is scared of me at the end of the day. I was in the same room with him at a PBC event. He saw me and he scattered off. And Deontay Wilder said in several other interviews that Dillian Whyte saw him and didn't say nothing. He was a mouse in the house. And then he went back over there to the UK. And now all of a sudden he wants to be the king of the jungle, the lion. He want to do all that roaring over there. But when he was in his presence, he didn't say nothing. But it's kind of funny to me that Whyte wants to respond now. Wilder's been saying this, that Whyte didn't say nothing when he was in his presence. He said that in several interviews. But all of a sudden you want to respond and say, nah, he saw me and he ran off. Now you want to respond. So I tend to believe Wilder was, you know, side of the story, because he's been saying that, and now Whyte all of a sudden wants to respond to that. This is not the first time he heard those comments by Wilder saying that he didn't say nothing when they were both at the PBC event, when Dillian Whyte was, you know, talking with Al Heyman about some potential fights and future fights done up under the PBC banner. So let me know your thoughts about this verbal warfare going down. I like to see this match up down the road. Don't make no mistake about it. Once Wilder finishes up with the Fury trilogy, and then if he wins that, he fights AJ and Undisputed and beats AJ, I'd like to see him fight Dillian Whyte next, man. That would be a good time matchup. The press conference would be epic. It would do good numbers in the UK and do good numbers in the United States. So let me know your thoughts about the comments made by Deontay Wilder and the response made by Dillian Whyte. Let me know your thoughts and hit the like button if you like the content of this video. And subscribe to JB Sports, the man, the myth, the legend. And I holler.